viewers, welcome all of you in Alka's Botany channel. Today we are going to learn general characters of algae part 1. I am Dr. Alka Inamdar in Alka's Botany channel. I thank all my viewers and subscribers. You subscribers and viewers really inspire me to bring up another great video. I promise a great botanical content for all the subscribers. So, please like, share and subscribe the channel and keep supporting. Distinguishing features of algae. They are photoautotrophs. They primarily in aquatic habitats. The vegetative body does not show any differentiation into various tissue systems. They show progressive complexity in reproduction. They do not develop embryo after fusion of gametes during sexual reproduction. Range of size from microscopic to single-celled organisms to large seaweeds. Many species of algae occur as a single cells, whereas others are multicellular also. In the general characters of algae, mainly a group of chlorophyll-containing thalloid plants are nothing but algae. Thallus is undifferentiated plant body. Algae plant body is not differentiated into true roots, stem and leaf or leaf-like organs. It is placed in the division Thallophyta along with fungi and lichens. Most of the algae are autotrophs. That means they synthesize their own food material with the help of light energy. They differ from fungi in two sense. Presence of photosynthetic pigment chlorophyll in algae, whereas it is absent in fungi. And mode of nutrition in algae is autotrophic because they have green colored chlorophyll. Whereas in fungi, chlorophyll is absent. That's why mode of nutrition is not autotrophic, but it is called heterotrophic. Habitat. Majority of the algae are aquatic, which is of universal occurrence. Sex organs are unicellular. Sex organs lack jacket cells around them. If jacket cells are present, they have different origin. There is a progressive complexity in reproduction. Embryos is not formed after zygote formation. They show distinct alternation of generations in their life cycle. Cellular organization may be prokaryotic or eukaryotic. Occurrence of algae shows variations. They found in variety of habitats. Fresh water, marine or on rocks, within plants or animals, aquatic forms are most common algae. On the basis of habitat, algae are classified into three groups, aquatic, terrestrial and unusual habitats. First one, that is aquatic algae. Aquatic forms are found in fresh water or in saline water of the sea. Freshwater algae mainly occurs in ponds, lakes, rivers, etc. And all of you know that Spirogyra is the best example of freshwater. Marine water, they occurs in saline condition, that is the seas and oceans, mainly members of brown algae and red algae, that is the sargassum in the marine water. Second one are terrestrial algae. They are found on soils, rocks, moist wall, trees, trunks, etc. Examples are Vaucheria, Fritzschia, found on the surface of soil. In addition to aquatic and terrestrial habitats, some algae occur in uncommon habitats, that is unusual. Halophytic algae, these algae are found in highly saline water. Epiphytic algae. Epi means above, phyton means plant. On the surface of other plants, on the surface of other algae, then it is called as epiphytic algae. Idogonium is the best example of epiphytic algae. zoic algae. Ippi means above, zoic means animal. On the surface of or on the skin of animals or on snails, fishes, etc. When algae found, then it is called epizoic algae. Cladophora grows on snails. Endozoic. Endo means inside and zoic means animal. So these algae are grow inside the animals. Chlorella is a algae which is found inside the hydra. That's why it is called zoochlorella. Symbiotic algae. Symbiotic association with fungi in lichens, in bryophytes, in pteridophytes, in gymnosperms, in angiosperms. Also, algae are show association. That is called symbiotic association. Parasitic algae. These are dependent on other plants or animals for their food or for shelter. Then it is called parasitic algae. Thermophytic algae, which grows in hot spring, that is in high ranges of temperature. Heterohermogonium is the example of thermophytic algae. In unusual habitats, cryophytic algae, which grow on ice or snow. These algae provide colors to snow-covered mountains. Alpines and Arctic mountains become red due to Haematococcus algae. Next, lithophytic algae grow on moist rocks and stones. Many blue-green algae like Nostoc, Rivularia and Gloeocapsa commonly grow on moist and shady rocks. Schistonema is common on moist walls during rainy seasons. So all that is about the habitat of the algae as an important general characteristic of algae. Thank you. Thank you very much.